The Philippine House of Representatives under the speakership of Congressman Lord Alan Velasco now taking shape following the announcement of a new minority leader. Congressman Joseph Stephen Carapspaduano, a three-time representative of Abang Lingkod Party List, replaces Manila lawmaker Benvenido Abante, who has since joined the House majority. Paduano has admitted voting for Velasco last week, a move which, based on House rules, should make him part of the majority. But Paduano cites precedents when then-Congressman Danilo Suarez became minority leader despite voting for then-Speaker Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. Nonetheless, Paduano guarantees the minority under his leadership will be an effective fiscalizer and balancing group. He argues this can be done better if someone from the minority assumes the chairmanship of the Public Accounts Panel.
Ngayon, ang medyo advantage lang is the minority na kailangan talaga yan without sacrificing the fiscalizing role. No, and balancing role of the minority, at least we have rapport to the speaker. Kasi kailangan mo niyan eh.
The Public Accounts Committee is currently chaired by Congressman Mike Defensor, who is allied with ousted Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano. Defensor has said the minority can have his post if they want. Independent opposition lawmaker Edsel Lagman also backs giving that panel to a House minority that is, quote, authentic. This, as he notes, of the now supposed formalized practice of the majority leadership handpicking the minority leader.
There is the more numerous supermajority, but there is a smaller aggregation of majority allies who masquerade as minority. I think they must be less than 20 at the moment.
As for perennial House minority members, the left-wing Amakabayan bloc, Paduano has received the minority's support by consensus and after due consultations. Paduano also dispels fears the majority has co-opted the House minority.
Binoto ako, unanimous. How can you influence? How can you co-opt the Makabayan Bloc? We operate in the principle of we agree to disagree.
Paduano has assured the public the minority will thoroughly scrutinize the amendments made in the proposed 2021 budget after the lower chamber approved it on third reading last week. This is Senator Panfilo Lacson calls out the House for allegedly committing numerous violations in the budget approval process. Lacson also flags the lower chamber for supposedly allowing the executive to have a say in passing the spending plan. But Senior Deputy Speaker Doy Lechon explains the institutional amendments made in the proposed budget after its passage on final reading did not alter the amounts discussed in the plenary. He guarantees the next national budget is free from any constitutional attack. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.